great majority of Ashkenazi Jews alive in the world today have their origin on the territory of Ukraine, as Robert Singer told us. But there are many stereotypes of the other and also stereotypes of ourselves. So we address those in order to enable fruitful, productive, loving collaboration between Jews and Ukrainians in Ukraine, Israel, Canada, around the world. Our stories basically are incomplete without each other. I hope you will all agree. The Shepitsky Prize is being awarded to, the Shepitsky Prize is named after, others will talk about him, but Cardinal Metropolitan Shepitsky was the most senior cleric of the Catholic Church, to have spoken up against Germany, Nazism, the campaign against Jews, and who actually sheltered Jews. None of the Jews, well over 100, who were sheltered by Metropolitan Shepitsky and his institutions were ever lost to the Jewish people. Every one of us returned to the Jewish fold. One of them is with us this evening, saved by Shepitsky and his brother Clement, Adam Rothfeld. Say that the next speaker I have the honor to introduce, Rabbi Yaakov Dov Black, Chief Rabbi of Ukraine, is now marking the 25th year of his service to Ukraine and the Jewish people. So he too deserves acknowledgement and credit for that. Kvod Harav.
Thank you very much, Beryl. And ladies and gentlemen, it is the third time that we are awarding the Metropolitan Andrei Shepitsky Medal. I must tell you how this came about. It came about from a conversation in my office with Jim Femery, head of the Ukrainian Jewish Council. And Jim asked me, what can we do to bring together Ukrainians and Jews? Ukrainian diaspora and the Jewish diaspora. What can we do to bring these peoples together? And we discussed different options. And I told Jim that one of the things that we as Jews would love to do is try and show thanks and acknowledge those Ukrainians that saved Jews. And I said, let's try and do something we can for Metropolitan Andrei Shepitsky. Metropolitan Shepitsky, as you all know, is the head of the Ukrainian Catholic Church in World War II. Saved over 100 Jews, as Beryl said. One of them is here with us in the room. I, myself, have been privileged to meet a number of these people. And amongst the Ukrainian community, there's this feeling that it's not God who decides who are the righteous among the nations. For some reason, they think it's Yad Vashem that makes that decision. And I'm trying to tell them, no, it's God. It's not Yad Vashem. And I said, I'll prove it to you. Metropolitan Andrei Shepitsky, who was a righteous Gentile who saved over 100 Jews. And even though Yad Vashem has not yet come to recognize him, we, the Jewish people, can still recognize him because we are sure that God does recognize him as a righteous person. And we subsequently made a trip of the Ukrainian Council of Churches and Religious Organizations to Canada, where the Canadian Parliament unanimously recognized Metropolitan Andrei Shepitsky. And many people were really excited because they said that they don't think that the Ukrainian Parliament could have done it unanimously. So it was good that we went to Canada and had it done there. And while we were in Canada, I came up with this idea. I said, we must come up with something that will eternalize its memory. And I thought of this medal, the Metropolitan Andrei Shepitsky Medal. And it's a gorgeous medal, which has the figure of Metropolitan Andrei Shepitsky on the front, with a quote from Psalms, which I chose, who will champion my cause against the wicked, who will stand for me against evildoers. And I think that that signifies what Metropolitan Andrei Shepitsky did. President Rivlin, President of Israel, spoke yesterday in the Ukrainian Parliament. He said that the victims of Babi Yar were double victims. They were killed, and then their memory was tried to be obliterated by the Nazis. The Nazis tried to burn any remains and tried to erase the memory of those that were killed. And President Rivlin said that whatever we'll do, we cannot bring back the dead. But let us never be partners with the second crime, the crime of trying to distort the history of what happened and erase the memory of those that killed. And I think that it is quite an interesting and a very, very unique opportunity we have today. Our first awardee was Jim Cameron, who received the Metropolitan Dishitsky Medal actually in President Ronald Reagan's house. We then celebrated it here with a dinner in Kiev. Our next awardee was Viktor Mikhailovich Kinchuk, who, as we all know, is, you know, sometimes I say the only philanthropist in Ukraine, but he's one of the greatest philanthropists in Ukraine, a Jew who has done a lot to bring together Jews and Ukrainians. I think that Metropolitan Shevchinsky did save Jews. He was able to save people from death. Tonight's honoree, Mr. Ivan Zuba, he has fought against that second victimization. He was one of the organizers that organized that first demonstration 50 years ago in Babi Yar to make sure that the memory of those that are killed will never ever be erased, that we should remember them forever. Today, much was spoken about the Jewish community of Kiev and its rebirth. I will close with a very interesting and poignant story. When I came to Kiev the first time for Yom Kippur, 26 years ago, so the Gabbai, who's in charge of the synagogue, he made an announcement. He said, in our synagogue, on Yom Kippur, everyone reads Kaddish, which is a memorial prayer that's read usually only by orphans. And I look at him and I said, my parents are alive. Can I read the Kaddish? He says, everyone in the synagogue reads the Kaddish on Yom Kippur. And I tried to figure out, why is it? And I started asking some of the elders in the community, and I figured out that everyone in the Jewish community lost relatives in Babi Yar. So every year, everyone would say Kaddish. Today, we have a young community. We have a community where people can't say Kaddish because their, thank God, parents are still alive. But we still have to say Kaddish. We still have to remember those that went. We have to understand that today's community, although it's young and active and growing community, it is built on the ashes of Babi Yar. And on the ashes of Babi Yar, we built a community today that's thriving, which is a testament not only to the eternity of the Jewish people, but to the dedication of the Ukrainian people and the Ukrainian government, that in Ukraine, we were successful in rebuilding a beautiful Jewish community that we can stand up and tell those that went, we can tell the victims of Babi Yar that we have not forgotten you, and we will carry on what you are not able to finish. Thank you very much.
And the judge to you, Rabbi Meyer. Toda Rabba. Metropolitan Shevchinsky may not be very well known to many of you who have come from near and far to be with us. So may I invite from the Greek Catholic Church the Marcus Bishop Boris Gudziak, of the church to come and tell us more about Cardinal Shevchinsky and his presentation, his introduction for many of us to Cardinal Shevchinsky will be followed by a short video.
Old Testament patriarch, listen carefully. tears streaming down his wrinkled cheeks. When I finished, he again embraced me, reflected a while, and suggested that I return in 2 days. Son, your father was my friend. You can rest assured that I will do all I can. Bring with you the manuscripts, and I will place them in a safe place. However, I have in mind to find a way to save you. These are the words of Kurt Levin, a successful businessman in Israel and in the United States, the son of the chief rabbi of Lviv, saved by Metropolitan Andrei Sheptytsky, who's been mentioned more in these days than any other of the righteous. And it's important to note that Ukraine is the fourth country in terms of quantity of those who saved Jews during the Holocaust. Metropolitan Andrei was like no other. I believe he was the greatest Ukrainian of the 20th century. A man who, at 35, became the head of a church and led it for 44 years, with 6 or actually 7 government changes, the Austrians, the Poles, the Ukrainian independence, the Soviets, the Nazis, the Soviets again, a patron of arts. No aspect of Ukrainian culture, no aspect of international relations, no aspect of the life of Ukrainians and their relations with Russians, Poles, and Jews was not marked by his creativity, his passion, and his generosity. When he came on visitations to parishes and Galician villages, the Jewish community would come out with the Torah and he would address them in fluent Hebrew. His brother was a Polish general fighting against the Ukrainian armies, but he always maintained a position of reconciliation with the Poles. And the passion of his life was a reconciliation between Catholics and Orthodox, between Russians and Ukrainians. It was mentioned that no hierarch in Europe, no Catholic or Orthodox bishop of his status, took such a clear stance against the killing in World War II. When the Holocaust began, with the utter bloodshed went rampant, he issued a pastoral letter, "Thou shalt not kill." No national, no political ideology justifies killing. He wrote to Himmler, and after Babyn Yar, in 1942, he wrote to Pius II about the slaughter of the Jews, the shooting of tens of thousands here in Kyiv. And so there is the Sheptytsky Medal. And there's a community of people here who are coming to know this legacy, which should become our orientation in life. Adam Rotfeld, saved by Sheptytsky, his brother, Clementi, and the Studa Monastic Network. Shimon Redli, a survivor, a professor who is fighting for the recognition of Sheptytsky's righteousness, a cause that I invite you all to join. The good rabbi said that God determines who the righteous are. Not always Yad Vashem, Let us all help Yad Vashem do what God has decided. In the case of Shapitsky, Father Omanan Coach, and others, the Ukrainians need to recognize where we have failed. We Christians need to repent where we have sinned, and we have sinned much. But our commemoration today will be futile if we do not strengthen our resolve to know the truth about God and man, about the world and relations between peoples and religions. It will be futile if we do not hear and see the witness of our righteous. In the end, Metropolitan Andrei embraced Kurt Levin, countless others, and throughout a lifetime, everyone he met, because he loved God and he loved his neighbor. That's what we live for, brothers and sisters. To love God and love our neighbor. Let the person and spirit of Metropolitan Andrei be before our eyes. That wrinkled face that Kurt Levin speaks about, the tears of compassion that pour down his cheeks, that embrace the marginalized, the suffering, the one in danger. We are before his person, and we are in the arms and embrace of the God he loved and served.